Yep.
Humans have a number of advantages even among terrestrial life. Our endurance, shock resistance, and ability to recover from injury is absurdly high compared to almost any other animal. We often use the phrase, healthy as a horse, to connote hardiness, but compared to a human, a horse is as fragile as spun glass. There's mounting evidence that our primitive ancestors would hunt large prey simply by following it at a walking pace without sleep or rest until it died of exhaustion. It's called pursuit predation. Basically, we're the Terminator. The only other animal that can sort of keep up with us is dogs. That's why we use them for hunting, and even then, it's only sort of. Our strength and speed is nothing to write home about, but we don't need to overpower or outrun you. We just need to outlast you, and by any other species standards, we just plain don't get tired. Where a simple broken leg will cause most species to go into shock and die, we can recover from virtually any injury that is not immediately fatal. Even traumatic dismemberment isn't necessarily a career-ending injury for a human. We heal from injuries with extreme rapidity, recovering in weeks from wounds that would take others months or years to heal. The results aren't pretty, though. Humans have hyperactive scar tissue among our other survival-oriented traits, but they're highly functional. Speaking of scarring, look at our medical science. We developed surgery centuries before developing even the most rudimentary anesthetics or life support. In extremis, humans have been known to perform surgery on themselves and survive. Thanks to our extreme hardiness, we regard as routine medical procedures what most other species would regard as inventive forms of murder. We even perform radical surgery on ourselves for purely cosmetic reasons. Our jaws have too many teeth in them, so we developed a way to weld metal to our teeth and force the bones in our jaw to restructure over the course of years to fit them back into shape, and then we continue to wear metal in our mouths to keep them in place. We formed cohabitive relationships with tiny mammals and insects we keep at bay from bothering us by death, often using little analog traps. And by God, we will eat anything. We use borderline toxic peppers to season our food. We will expose ourselves to potentially lethal solar radiation in the pursuit of purely darkening our skin. We risk hearing loss for the opportunity to see our favorite musicians live. We have a game where two people get into an enclosed area and hit each other until time runs out or one of them passes out. We willingly jump out of planes with only a flimsy piece of cloth to prevent us from splattering against the ground. Our response to natural disasters is to just rebuild our buildings in the exact same places. We climb mountains and risk freezing to death for bragging rights. We invented dogs. We took our one-time predators and completely domesticated them. On a planet full of lions, tigers, and bears, we managed to advance further and faster than any other species on the planets. It's one thing... Okay, pursuit predation. It's one thing to face down a cheetah, which will slam into you at 60 miles an hour and break your neck. It's another thing to run very quickly to get away from something, only to have it kind of show up. To have it be intelligent enough to figure out where you are by the fur and feather you've left behind, your footprints, your pee and crap. And then you think you've lost it and you bed down for the night, but there it is, waiting when you wake up and you split again. But it keeps following you, always in the corner of your eye, until you just die. We are scary.